Another edition of Sam Choy's in the Kitchen. I'm John Veneri. This is the chef, Sam Choy. We are visiting another chef, Lillian Cumic.
And guess what? She's the queen of green cuisine.
I love that. A vegan chef that has a couple of books out. She's gonna make some of her recipes and we're gonna make one of our own.
Right.
Here we go. Hi!
Aloha,
Aloha.
Chef.
Welcome.
Thank
Come
you.
In.
Hello,
Hello
Chef.
John. Nice to meet
Thanks
you.
Thanks for having us. Please My show pleasure. Us to the kitchen.
This way. When I found out Sam and John were coming to my kitchen to cook with me, I was so excited. I'm a huge fan of Chef Sam Choy, so I was just telling everyone I know and really looking forward to this moment.
Well, let's let everybody know that Lillian is the queen of green cuisine.
That's right.
So let's go ahead and pull whatever we're gonna start making out and we'll get started.
Let's do it.
Okay,
yep.
Great. Uncle Sam,
I think you're all open for
Okay.
Two doors or just one?
There's no surprise here, it's her kitchen.
You can do two doors.
Okay, go
the
ahead.
The star of the show is going to be this, oops.
I do have a question for you as far as tofu, since you know all about tofu. I would like to know like what particular tofu you like to shop for.
Definitely the Aloha tofu.
Oh,
none of these are fried. All of these have been pressed. So I like to label things so that when I'm ready to cook, it's just ready to go.
Okay.
Because I cook so much. Right. With my recipe developing, yeah. I like to have them all ready.
So, for example, twice medium frozen.
Yes. When you freeze tofu, you actually manipulate the texture of it, and it's easier to release the frozen crystals from the pores of the tofu, which you have to get out, enable for tofu to soak up the flavors. So, contrary to what people think, tofu doesn't soak up its sauces and juices unless it has been drained.
Well, I can already feel like the texture is different.
The firmness.
I usually get a firm tofu. This feels way firmer than the one that I normally buy.
Okay, what you are going to notice is it becomes very spongy.
Okay.
So once you have defrosted the tofu once, it goes back into the freezer again for a second freezing.
Okay.
That's how the name twice frozen comes about. Then you, again, defrost the tofu, and then you're gonna press it and it's gonna look something like this.
Whoa, look at this.
Oh, this is a really great invention, the tofu press, because it just makes life so much easier.
Where did you get this from? I want one.
Online.
Really?
Available online, and they're only around $20, but if you eat a lot of tofu and you want to start, you know, cooking tofu the right way, preparing it the right way, I definitely recommend a tofu press.
What are we gonna do?
I was thinking today, because Chef Sam Choy was such an inspiration for me when I moved to the islands and when I was writing my book.
Mm-hmm.
I would like to do my rendition of Sam Choy's tofu poke.
Ooh, yes, please. Okay.
That's a deal.
I like that. Okay, bing, bing. Let's get started.
Okay, so we have put some olive oil, half a teaspoon of olive oil, 1 tablespoon of shoyu, and 2 tablespoons of cornstarch to coat.
And this is medium, twice frozen, and yours is?
Mine is the extra firm tofu that has been pressed.
Mine's going in the air fryer, yours is going in the oven.
Yes.
I like this, is great, okay.
Awesome. We'll see which one tastes better.
Okay. Okay, I've never used an air fryer like this, but I'm...
Okay.
Should I dump it in or by hand?
Yes, you can dump it in, yeah.
Stand on the side, John. Yep. There you go.
Great, okay. So 15 minutes, 350 degrees for
15 minutes, 350, okay. I haven't done a tofu in an air fryer yet, so I'm curious to know how this will turn out.
Okay, yes.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to
it. I'm excited. And mine's going in at 400 degrees. For 20 to 25 minutes. So I'm from Sydney, Australia, and when I was 18, I moved to Japan, where I ended up staying for 30 years, and that's where I started my career in the food industry and became a chef. And I just moved to Hawaii 3 years ago. One thing I always have in my kitchen is the thin strips of kombu. Basically, you just soak them in water for 5 minutes and they end up like that. And you just roughly chop that. That's my substitute for obol. So that can go into the bowl. And then we're going to add some sweet onion or Maui onion, just some minced onion and some sliced green onion, which I've already sliced. Okay. And along with that is my secret ingredient that I always put in my tofu poke, sambai zuke. Ooh. It's just pickled radish in a nice shoyu base.
From our good friends.
Yep.
Which I love. And that's also just been roughly chopped.
Okay.
Excellent. Candle nuts are also a little bit difficult to find, so I'm using just the Hawaiian macadamia.
Okay.
With sea salt.
You chop that up too?
Yes.
He beats it.
John?
She beats it.
Don't be scared. This is going to be, just use this to chop it, then you don't have to.
We're beating macadamia nuts here.
Another way you can do that is in a Ziploc bag.
Yes.
In a small scale.
Yeah. Yep. Yeah, that's great. Perfect.
Sure.
Don't mind the little chunks, that's good. You want some texture in there. I actually do this with a lot of different nuts.
Yeah.
Okay, now what?
All right, and now we're just going to go and add some shoyu.
Okay.
1.5 tablespoons. Perfect. And then vinegar about the same. I'm using rice vinegar.
Uh-huh.
Apple cider vinegar would work as well.
The rice vinegar has the sodium in there, which is good.
Yeah, and then some sesame oil. I would just put about 2 teaspoons, chef.
1, 2.
Okay, great. The other thing I like to add, I added some sambal oelek, and I really like it because it does have a little bit of garlic in it as well. So I'm going to go ahead and add maybe just a little bit. You don't want too much.
Is it spicy?
A little bit.
It is, a little bit. That's only 3/4 teaspoon.
I'm no longer afraid of spice.
And the other thing I want to add is some kombu dashi, which is the kelp flakes. I get these from Nigeria.
Okay.
That adds a little bit
the
of
whole
umami.
Packet?
No, no, no. That's 1 teaspoon, yeah.
That's good.
That's good enough.
Yes. The tofu is ready.
We're going to put it right in here and then just,
yes.
Ooh, okay.
But first, John and Chef Sam, can I ask you to try a piece? Because I think you're going to be very surprised at the texture. Take care, because it is hot.
Oh, I like that.
It's kind of lost its tofiness.
Wow. Huh? But it has a nice flavor.
Mm-hmm.
That's good.
And really, you can incorporate the crispy baked tofu into any dish you like, whether it's a stir fry or a salad.
Uh-huh. We'll do the Portuguese stir. 5 guys hold a bowl, 1 guy's there. This is really tasty.
And now we're just going to roughly chop the watercress, half the tomatoes, sprinkle on some sesame seeds, and then we're good to go. Excellent. So give it a nice toss, John, and then we can plate it.
That looks really nice.
I don't have to worry about breaking up the tofu now. I like the colors.
Yeah, the colors are beautiful.
Can't wait to taste it. Is that dish number one?
That is.
Dish number one, done. Dish number two is with what we put into the oven, the tofu that went into the oven. What are we doing with this one?
Mm-hmm. So this one we're going to make a Korean style crispy gochujang tofu.
Mm-hmm.
And what we're going to add to it is my favorite grain, which is quinoa.
Okay.
I've toasted the quinoa before adding the water, and basically it's cooked exactly the way you would cook rice. So are you ready, John, to make the sauce?
Let's do it.
Okay. A couple of tablespoons of gochujang.
You like this one?
Yeah.
Okay. Is that good?
That's great.
Okay.
And then we're going to add a little bit of vinegar.
Oh!
And about the same amount of water. This gochujang can be very, potent, so we do want to thin it out a little bit with some water. Give that a stir, John.
I could, yeah.
Sam Choi is in the kitchen. Hotel accommodations provided by Ala Moana Hotel.
We love our avocados. Problem is, when you buy a bag, they tend to ripen at the same time. some of it will go to waste unless you know what to do with overripe avocado. Avocados make a great salad dressing. Mash and mix with plain yogurt, a little chili powder, or your preferred spice to give it a little kick, and spoon over your greens. If the fruit is still firm enough to cut, peel and slice into slivers and dredge into tempura batter. When nice and brown, sprinkle with salt and it's good to go. If you prefer a dessert tempura, top with chutney and feta sprinkles. Avos are loaded with healthy fats and vitamin E, so good for your skin. For a healthy face mask, add a little lemon juice and apple cider vinegar to mashed avocados to tighten pores and brighten skin. Uncooked oatmeal is a terrific exfoliant. Your skin will thank you. Now back to Sam in the kitchen.
A splash of some ginger, some garlic, 2 to 3 cloves of chopped garlic or just the minced just garlic. A little bit of liquid gold. Okay. What do you think, Chef?
That's good.
A little bit of toasted sesame oil, which I love.
Okay.
Awesome. Great. And then you can add the green onion, about a quarter cup of sliced green onion, and then a tablespoon of toasted white sesame seeds. The quinoa is actually a quarter of a cup of dried quinoa, so it yields about half a cup. I'm going to get out the tofu.
Okay.
So here's our crispy baked tofu. This was the extra firm tofu we baked for 20 minutes. You can see it's a little bit different appearance to the one that we had in the air fryer. Not quite as crisp, still firm. I'm going to put that in. And then now all we want to do is just add the baby leaf.
This looks amazing.
I'll give you a bigger one.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Wait,
John.
Please, throw them first. Okay, sorry. You're the boss.
No. Yeah. She's the boss.
You can go ahead and plate that.
Dish number 2 from Chef, the queen of green cuisine, is pow.
Beautiful.
Chef Lillian's dishes are done. Ours is on deck. But first, bok choy. Would you do the honors?
Absolutely.
Okay. Pull it out, show the camera. Here, I'll do the honors with this one.
Uh-huh.
We have Uncle Sam, chocolate macadamia
nut rosin.
We'll be having that for dessert.
Mm, okay.
Would you mind pulling the other ingredients?
Sure.
Salty wahine, Hawaiian sea salt.
Yep.
And salty wahine.
That looks great.
Hawaiian star fruit lemon pepper.
That's what we're gonna use.
We can use that for this?
Yes. Well, you have no choice.
We have to.
My favorite, rosani. Let's go golfing.
And that's bok choy.
So cool.
Uncle Sam, what are we making?
Well, we're making kind of like Carol's famous vegetable stir fry. Okay, I'm gonna add carrots now, okay? So if you guys take notice, the cuts is called a 3/4 turn cut. We're gonna add the potatoes. Why do you think we're adding the potatoes and the carrots first?
Well, because of the texture and how long it takes for them to cook.
Uh-huh. Okay, then we have Hawaiian sea salt.
I like that idea of keeping the cap on and just
control it. And then, you can just do this right here and you just, just like that.
Clever, yeah. Okay. It's easier to see how much you're actually adding.
Yes. Okay, now, apple cider vinegar.
Mm.
Really?
Yeah.
This is your stock.
That's my stock, yeah. Yum. A little bit.
This is going to be yummy.
Is this vegan?
It is, yes.
Really?
Ketchup is, it is vegan. Or what we call...
So is Oreos cookies.
I know.
Yeah, right.
No, it is. Ask her.
My husband was has never been so excited when he found out that Oreo's cookies are actually vegan. Accidentally vegan.
Was your husband vegan before he
met you? He's not vegan now.
He's not?
No.
Wow, so you guys cook totally different.
No, our home is vegan, so okay. We only cook vegan here.
And but if he wants something, he has to go outside and get it.
So when we go out, he eats whatever he wants.
The honey.
Honey, okay. And again, what is in this?
Apple juice, cane sugar, a little bit of lemon juice, and some chamomile tea bags.
I love that. That's so awesome. Okay, now you're gonna put did you say this was frozen, but it is pressed?
It's not frozen, but it is pressed.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
So it should soak up the sauce nicely. Okay.
So John, give him your nice little, yeah.
Are you using the rest of that cilantro for topping?
Yes, we'll just put that right there.
For beautifying?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I like that.
Okay, here we go. Get it nice and covered in that sauce. And it's a sweet and sour.
Perfect bowl, look at this.
Yeah.
Did we plan this?
Beautiful.
That's it.
So, two poke dishes, a vegan stew. It's that time. You know what time it is.
Yes.
What time it is?
It's time to
grind.
Very good.
All right, chef, let's recap your two dishes since we went first. And the first one was that one.
The tofu poke, the crispy tofu poke with the pressed and twice frozen tofu that we made. Just added typical poke dressing flavors and tossed it with some watercress.
I wouldn't say typical. Your dressing was amazing.
Yeah. Thank
All
you.
All made from scratch, by the way. Okay, and then next?
And the next one was the crispy tofu gochujang. So that has some nice Korean flavors, also tossed through the toasted quinoa for a little bit of a twist. And I've placed it in some nice little purple cabbage leaves.
So presentation is key.
Hey, you know what? That's chef right here.
So presentation with taste good is always great. And last and then, but not least.
Yeah, we did a nice, like a sweet sour braised vegetables with tofu. But the interesting thing, we have your honey in here. And I think your honey just kicked it up to another level.
Well, you know what? You just kicked up my ego to a whole new level, because not many people can say Chef Sam Choy has not only cooked for you, but also added my vegan honey. So thank you.
Yeah, your vegan honey was very good. So a bunch of vegetables, you know, eggplant, three different color peppers. I added some carrots and potatoes. And then I just took the tofu that you had squeezed really nice and firm. And then folded it in that nice sauce. And it's like an interesting dish. It's like stew.
Mm-hmm.
You let it sit, it gets better.
Yeah,
we can taste that.
Yeah. So I'll soak in. And then no, this is not alcohol. We are drinking lemon and ginger.
Lemon ginger water, yep. With ginger syrup.
This is great.
Lemon.
Shall we?
Yes. Yep.
I'll give this one to you.
Thank you, tadakimasu.
Yep.
Take one of those, Sammy. I'll take one of these myself. I'll trade you.
Thank you.
Okay, while we're doing that, the honey that we were talking about came out of this book, yes?
My second book, yes, Tasting Hawaii Vegan Style. It just came out last November, published locally with Mutual Publishing.
Congratulations.
And you're
Thank
working
you.
On your third.
I am writing my third book. I'm going to take it a bit slow. I never know what the book's going to lead to. It kind of creates itself as I go along, but it won't be Hawaii themed because the first two books were both Hawaii themed books.
I want to know, do you do any recipes online? Do you do something on your social media? What do you do?
Mm-hmm. I often post recipes on my social media. Mm-hmm. You can just find me at lillianvegan.com.
Bingo, there you go, you're welcome.
If anyone would like to get a copy of my book, a signed copy of my book, you can come down to the Kakaako Farmers Market on March 12th. It's a Saturday, and I'll be there, and you can pick up a copy of my book and get cooking in the kitchen.
Well, thank you so much for having us over, for making a couple of great dishes that I plan on doing and recreating at home. and just having us over. Thanks for the chat.
Honestly, the pleasure's been mine. I love your show, and to be honored to be on your show is such an honor. To have, you know, Chef Sam Choy at my table again, it's really exciting. You will always have a seat at my table.
Aw, thank you. Right, Uncle Sam?
That's right.
Can I actually come back?
Yeah.
You sure?
We'll make it happen.
Perfect. I apologize we didn't bring dessert for you, but Uncle Sam, we have Rosalani ice cream.
Oh, my favorite.
But remember,
when Sam Choi's in the kitchen,
you can do the cooking.
Chef Sam Choy, Choy. No, come on. Please come by house, look my icebox. Our food is complimentary. And please bring John Canary.
Beat it, John, beat it. Beat it, beat it. Oh, again.